In part 3 of our lesson on trigonometric functions of non-acute angles, you are going to learn about finding an angle given a trig function value. We'll work through 4 steps to accomplish this, so let's get right into the first example here, where you're asked to find all values for theta in the interval 0 degrees to 360 degrees, where cosine of theta is equal to negative radical 3 over 2. So let's make sure you understand this interval. Because of the hard bracket on the 0 degrees, 0 is included, so 0 could be a potential answer. And because of the soft bracket on the 360, 360 is not included, so 360 could never be one of your answers. Okay, step 1. Determine the quadrants of theta based on the trig function value and the positive or negative sign. So we see we have cosine, and it has to be negative. Now we know cosine is negative in quadrants 2 and 3. Step 2 says draw a diagram indicating the possible locations for theta. So we're going to draw an angle in quadrant 2 and an angle in quadrant 3. Step 3 says we have to determine the reference angle using the given trig value and the special angle chart. Now we know that on the special angle chart, all the values are positive. So for a minute now, we're just going to ignore the negative sign, and we're looking on the chart for where the cosine of a reference angle is equal to radical 3 over 2. And we see, looking at the special angle chart, that theta r has to be 30 degrees. Step 4 says indicate theta r on the drawing and then use it to find the angle or angles. So we know that 30 degrees has to be between each terminal side and the nearest x-axis, so we label theta r on the picture. Now we know that this would be 180 degrees, and we can find two angles here. We see the first angle we could find by starting at 180 and backing up by 30 degrees, so that would be 180 minus 30 degrees, which is 150 degrees. There's a second angle in our picture, and we see we would start at 180 and go 30 degrees more, so that means we would do 180 degrees plus 30 degrees and get 210 degrees. So both of these angles have their cosine would be negative rad 3 over 2, so our solution here is that theta is equal to 150 degrees or 210 degrees. This next example has the same instructions. We have to find all values for theta in the interval 0 to 360 degrees, where tangent of theta is equal to 1. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. Now, step 1, we have to determine the possible quadrants for theta based on the trig function and the positive and negative sign. So we notice that we have tangent is positive, and tangent theta will be positive in quadrants 1 and 3. Step 2 says to draw a diagram. So we'll put angles in quadrant 1 and in quadrant 3. Next, we have to find theta r using the trig value and the special angle chart. So we have to find the reference angle so that the tangent of that reference angle is equal to 1. And looking at the chart, we see that our reference angle is going to be 45 degrees. Last, we have to put the reference angle on our drawing. So this would be 45 degrees. This would be 45 degrees. And then we're going to use that to determine the angles. So we know here the nearest x-axis would be at 0. So our first angle would be starting at 0 and going up by 45 degrees. So we're going to end at 45 degrees. Our second angle is going to start here. This is the nearest x-axis at 180 degrees. So we would start at 180 degrees and add our reference angle of 45, and we get to 225 degrees. So those are our two solutions. In this third example, we have the same instructions. We have to find all values for theta in the interval 0 degrees to 360 degrees, this time where sine of theta is equal to negative radical 3 over 2. Let's check your understanding. So pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, step 1 is to determine the quadrants based on the trig function and the positive and negative sign. So we know that sine of theta will be negative in quadrants 3 and 4. So step 2 says to make the drawing. So we're going to put an angle in quadrant 3 and an angle in quadrant 4. Next, we have to determine the reference angle using the trig value and the special angle chart. So we have to find the sine of a reference angle, and it has to equal, remember, you ignore the negative sign, so it has to equal positive rad 3 over 2, since the reference angle chart doesn't have any negative angles on it. So we go to the sine row, go over to rad 3 over 2, and go up, and we see that our reference angle is going to be 60 degrees. The fourth step is to indicate theta r on the drawing and use it to determine theta. So we know theta r will be here, 60 degrees, and here, 60 degrees. The nearest x-axis here is at 180 degrees. So theta 1, we would start out at 180 degrees, add 60, and find out that we are at 240 degrees. For our second angle, we would start here And now that would mean we're starting at 360 degrees and we're backing up by 60 degrees. So the second angle would be starting at 360 degrees and subtracting 60 degrees, ending up at 300 degrees. So these are the two solutions. Theta equals 240 degrees or 300 degrees. To summarize, here's your toolkit for finding special angles in the interval 0 to 360 degrees. You will need these three items: your chart showing the sines of the trig functions, your special angle chart giving the trig function values, and the four steps for finding an angle given the trig function value.